Hey all, in this tutorial, you're going to learn how to edit a video from start to finish using original footage. The program we're using is called Adobe Premiere Rush, which is essentially a slimmed down version of Premiere. You can edit on a phone, you can edit on a tablet, or you can edit on a computer. It's gonna be really fun. We're using an interview from a woman named Tina who developed a teleporter. And you're going to be able to follow along every step of the way and edit on your own computer right alongside me. We're going to look at the transcripts of the interview. We're going to look at the script. We're going to import the media that we want to edit with, work with VoiceOver, and then we're going to do a final export of your project. You can even add music to it if you want. So let's get started. This is the file that I prepared for you. It is just called tinateleporter.zip. The first thing you want to do is if you have it in your downloads, go ahead and move it to your desktop. We're going to edit directly from this file. Double click it, and then it will open the file onto your desktop. At this point, you could delete the zip file, or you could just hold on to it for later. It's up to you. I'm gonna open it up. If you're using a tablet or a phone, you can just work with the files themselves and you don't necessarily need this whole structure, but it's good to keep everything in one folder. In my documents folder, I have a few documents. I have the Tina Teleporter script, and then I also have the Tina Teleporter interview transcript. Beginning with the transcript, Tina Teleporter is the person we're speaking to. She has these numbers next to where she speaks, and that is called a time code. At 0000, that means 0 minutes, 0 seconds. So basically that means that's the beginning of the clip. Quick definition, when I say clip, I am referring to an individual video file. Tina begins by saying, I am the inventor of, and then I ask her, hey, hold on, Tina. And I say that at 0002, which means 0 minutes, 2 seconds. So this is how the time code works. This is very useful because when you look at a clip, that time code will correspond to when you drag left and right, and you can find the exact words that you're looking for just by looking at the time code. So this is the full interview that we had, and if I scroll to the bottom, you can see it really wasn't that long. 6:45 is the last line that she said. Let's take a look at the next document we have. It is called the Tina Teleporter script. I like to do 2-column scripts. On one side, I'm going to put the words, and then on the other side, I'm going to put the visuals. So we're going to be editing from this script. Quickly looking over the script, there are 2 lines from Tina, and they have a time code listed. So if we're going to go into the file and try to pull out these portions in Premiere Rush, we can refer to this time code. There is then a voiceover that comes from myself, which we are going to be using. And this is a single line, which is an MP3 that I recorded separately. The difference between Tina's interview is there's video and audio. And then from this voiceover, there's no videos, only audio. Over here on the visual side, we have a lower third, which is a title. We're going to give her a name on screen in text. And then we have a B-roll clip that we're going to use. B-roll are elements that are neither scenes or interview. B-roll is essentially additional footage that provides context to what you're seeing on screen. A few other things in folders that I have are music, project, if you notice, is an empty folder, and that's intentional because we're going to put our project into there. Next we have Scratch, and Scratch is also empty. Next in the video folder we have 3 files. The first file is called Teleporter B-roll. This is B-roll or footage of the teleportation device. Very beautiful, you can see it's super high tech. And then I have this clip of the teleporter factory. This is where the device is made. And then last but not least is the interview with Tina Teleporter. That is Tina, and you can hear her speaking about her device.
I am the inventor of...
This is the file that corresponds with our script and our transcript when it comes to time code. The last thing we have is a folder for voiceover. Off camera, Tina told me the side effects for men include itchiness and blindness. This is our first footage of the manufacturing floor. A trick I learned with Rush for the import process, to have everything in the same folder is often really helpful. So I'm going to tell you exactly what files you need to bring into your project folder. The 3 video files, the music file, and the voiceover. And bring it all into the project folder. Now we have everything that we're going to be working with in one place. And let's open up Premiere Rush. It will take a second to start the first time. Oh, that was fast. Okay, so Premiere Rush is open. We're going to create a new project. On your desktop, you do have this folder that you've already set up. That's perfect. And then we're going to click into the project folder right here. Now that you're in the project folder, you see the 5 assets that we have pulled into the folder. And what I'm going to have you do is click all 5 of those, and then we're going to give our project a name. We're going to go down to the bottom, and where it says project name, give it a name that reflects what you're going to be editing. In this case, I'm just going to call it Teleporter. Now we're ready to begin. Hit Create at the bottom right. Now you can see all of our files have been brought into the project. So down here, this area is called your timeline. See these numbers for 30, 1 minute, 130? That is your time code. To play, you can hit space, and then it plays the entire interview. This is just your raw footage laid out in what we call a sequence on the timeline. In the bottom left, you have the basic tools that you'll be using to edit. They are split, and the shortcut for split is just S. If you hover over any section by clicking above, right beneath the numbers on the timeline, you'll see that this blue line with a little indicator moves. This is actually called a current time indicator, but some people just call it the playhead. When you click around, you can see different parts of your video. You can also select the current time indicator and move it left and right to scrub. So now we know the basics of how to get around here, but let's talk about some of the tools that you'll use most frequently. The first tool is this little scissors. It is split, to split any clip. So let's say I just wanted to split right here where the current time indicator is. I would select the area where I want to split my clip in half and then hit S. And now this is 2 separate clips. If I wanted to undo this, a quick hotkey is Command Z or Control Z, which just reverses the last action that you took. The next tool, Duplicate, will make a copy of the clip and put it right behind the clip that you have. So if I clicked Duplicate right here, now I have a second clip. And you can see if I drag at the bottom that it made a complete copy of that long interview. This time, instead of hitting Command Z to go back, I'm going to delete it by hitting Delete. Another way to delete, of course, is just to hit the trash can down here. So that's your third tool. It is the Delete tool. And if I want to delete a clip, just click this. The next tool is really helpful. It's called Expand Audio, so that you can see what we call that audio track more clearly. It drops down and expands. All of these little lines in here are actually your audio visualized. And now a more advanced feature is the very bottom tool, which is Control Tracks. If I click this lock, I can't move anything in here. It's just going to stay where it is. I can unlock it. I can also make a track invisible by hitting this eyeball, and it just goes away. The reason I would want to do that is sometimes you layer your tracks one on top of the other like Legos. You might just want to see what's beneath it. For now, I'm going to hit Control Tracks again to get rid of those options. So if you want to add more things to your project or see everything in your project, that's also very easy. These tools are up at the top left. There is a plus, which allows you to add more media. And there is also this box. If you hit the box, it shows you everything that's currently in your file. So we're going to start with what I call a radio cut, which is making an edit just from the interview so that we can listen to it, make sure it sounds good, and then we're going to add other things to it. So let's delete everything else and just start with the interview. When I hit minus a few times, I can see everything. So we have our full interview. We need to start cutting it down, and we're going to look at the script and see what are the moments that we have to take out. One way that we can do this is by dragging left and right on the edge of a clip to remove part of it. Another way to do it is to hit S at our time codes whenever we feel like we want to make a split. That's the way we're going to do it today. Let's take a look at the script. Let's look for the first lines from Tina that we're going to use in the edit. Hi, I'm Tina Teleporter. I invented the carrier, which is a teleporter that can take you anywhere in the world. That's around 10 seconds. So we're going to go over to our timeline, zoom in a bit. I'm pressing plus here, and I can drag on the left at the bottom, and I'm getting to this 10 second point. The audio starts about right here, so let's take a listen to it and see if that's it.
Hi, I am Tina Teleporter, and I invented the carrier, which is a teleporter that can take you anywhere in the world.
That's it. What I want to do is cut that portion out. I'm going to be splitting those clips, and then I'm going to move on to the next clip that we need to find. At the beginning of this, I'm going to take my playhead, drag it right before that audio starts, press S, and we split that clip. Let's play it to the end and then hit space to stop it. The last word here is world, so let's play it through and stop it after world.
Hi, I am Tina Teleporter, and I invented the Carrier, which is a teleporter that can take you anywhere in the world.
Okay, so I stopped it, and if I look here, I may have stopped it a tad early. Editing for me is really visual. I like to use my eyes to determine where to make my cuts. So I'm gonna pull my indicator to an area where I know it's quiet, splitting that. We're done with our first section from Tina. I like to call that a bite. It's just like a bite-sized bit of information. So zooming out one last time, we can take a look at all the pieces we have from Tina. We have these three small clips that we selected by splitting. And we can get rid of everything else at this point. Click the other chunks and delete them. Okay, we're gonna pull in the voiceover now. It's really short and you can just drag and drop it onto your timeline. Now, because there's no video track and you're not going to see a preview of any image like you would see for your other tracks that are video tracks with audio. And you can tell it's just audio because of the color. This is a good time to use the control tracks tool that I mentioned earlier. So we're going to click down at the bottom and bring it back. And what we can do is mute the audio from our video file so that we only hear the audio from the voiceover. You notice the audio track goes gray. Now when we play it back, we should only hear the green audio from the voiceover track. Tina told me the side effects for men include itchiness and blindness. So let's clip it at 6 seconds, select the track, and then hit S. Now we've split it, and I'm going to delete everything that came before it. So this is where editing gets fun. In Rush, it's not always easy to just drag an audio file in between two video files because it's trying to help you not to have any gaps in your projects. So what you could do is bring in some more footage that can live on top of that audio. So in our script, what I decided to do was to use B-roll of the factory to come in when this audio is playing. To bring in B-roll of the factory, we simply drag and drop it. And we can put it right between the two clips. Click the audio track of the voiceover and then just move it over to the right. So let's play this and see how it looks. But should that many teleporters be manufactured before we even know how it works? The factory footage goes on a bit too long. To shorten the factory footage, we can just click the footage and then drag on the edge of it to pull it to the left. Another way that we could do it is like we did before and just make a split. Over on the visual side, we see the first thing that we're missing is this lower third for Tina Teleporter. A lower third is just an indicator of a person's name and title. The rest of the tools that you use in Rush are over here in the top right, and these are effects panels that can give you different appearances, transitions. The one that we're going to use first is graphics. Clicking graphics opens up a side panel, and we're going to add a graphic. So click Add Graphic. The way we use this is by dragging it into the project. You want to drag it on top of your video file. You can click directly on the screen and edit your title just by typing. I'm going to make this font smaller. You can also type in a number over here by clicking on the side. So I'm going to type in 55. And then the subtitle, I'm going to call her Inventor. The next thing I notice is B-roll of the teleporter to cover a jump cut. This is what we call a jump cut when two clips are side by side that have similar framing, and there is a passage of time that takes place which makes it look kind of jarring.
In the world, this is a miniaturized.
So we can pull this teleporter B-roll in. Let's scrub through and play it. That's where I'm going to begin. And then we're going to pull this over to cover that cut. That is our complete video. To export in Rush, you hit share up at the top. The first thing that we want to do is give it a name. So I'm going to keep it consistent. I'm going to give it the name that I used at the beginning, which is Teleporter. And then you can decide where to save it. Click this right here, it brings up a window and you can select where you should save your project. So since we had it on the desktop, I'm going to navigate to the Tina Teleporter folder. And I actually want to make a new folder in here called Exports. So I'm going to hit New Folder, and I'm going to create a folder called Exports. I select Choose. It gives you an estimated file size, which tells you about how much space this will take up on your device. Under Advanced Settings, you can choose your resolution. 1080 is fine. Preset, I'm going to keep it at automatic. We discussed frame rate in another video, but we shot this at 23.976 frames per second, so we can match that here. Audio channel stereo, that means we're going to hear from both channels, left and right. They're not going to be duplicated. Under quality, you can select low, medium, or high, and that does adjust the file size. Whenever you have space available, go ahead and select high. The final step is just to click export at the bottom. A quick way to find your file after you export is to click View in Finder, and it will bring it right up. Before you close out, you want to watch your file and make sure that it's exactly how you wish. So I'm going to open that with QuickTime.
Hi, I am Tina Teleporter, and I invented the Carrier, which is a teleporter that can take you anywhere in the world. This is a miniaturized version of what we're working on, and we're hoping that we can release it to the public.
This is our first footage of the manufacturing floor. Tina says she can put out more than 1,000 units a month. But should that many teleporters be manufactured before we even know how it works?
I can show you how it works. Can go ahead with that. All right. And here we go. 3, 2. Hold on a second. See, it works.
In Rush, you can hit done. And then now you can close your project by going to File, Close Project. And you can just close out of the program. And that is it. You've completed your first project in Adobe Rush. As you continue to experiment, you can play with more of the effects, more of the transitions, and make things look exactly how you wish. So thank you for watching, and good luck editing your first stories.